We want to do business with people that believe what we believe. And it is really easy in this business to get seduced into price-based selections. It's really easy.
It's very important to this company that people be treated well. And I think that that's very valuable.
I think it just comes back to the culture. You know, you whatever the job is in construction, it's going to be fairly similar no matter where you work in terms of the, you know, day-to-day nuts and bolts. But it's the company culture that's going to be different.
So that culture has been cultivated by lots of people before us. And so kudos to them. I think we've got a responsibility to carry that culture forward. I think it all comes down to just, it's kind of cliche to say, but we're like a family.
I tell people all the time, we are in the ultimate team sport. Everything we do is a prototype. We only do it once with a unique set of people in a unique set of circumstances at a unique point in time in a unique place.
Technology is what helps us to keep track of all this. I cannot imagine what people went through in the past to run a, you know, an $80, $90, $100 million company. We could not do that at all without technology.
Here at the office, we incorporate it in quite a few ways. We use it for collaboration with people on the project teams. We use it for planning, projecting, keeping our accounting.
We like to say that construction accounting is harder than other types of accounting. There's just a lot of different elements to it.
We're trying to find ways as a company, as an industry, and as a company to find the technology that complements the work and supports the work, as opposed to technology that might distract from the men and women that are putting units in place.
I've heard before it asked what keeps CFOs up at night. I could see if you don't have a trusted partner in that area, that'd keep me up at night. If I didn't know who I was gonna call about these problems, that'd be concerning.
Just from my experience with it, I have confidence that if we can't solve something in-house, we can reach out and get a solution through Bangert.
You know, we're in construction, that's our expertise. I'm in accounting, that's my expertise. Deal a lot with IT, but I'm not an expert there. And I need somebody looking out for our best interest. And that's a part I think that Bangert does well for us, is just considering how we could maybe do something differently or purchase something else to make things better for us. Bangert, like Story, has a great culture of caring people that are trying to make a difference.
It's a huge industry. They're just ginormous companies. We're a pretty small data point, but I'd like to think a meaningful enough one to come here and explore, because we can do things at our scale that a lot of the big folks can't. We're transitioned from a family-owned to an employee-owned company, and that really leads to a culture of ownership throughout the company from top to bottom, I think, that makes us unique.